Right, firstly, congratulations to all of you. Some of you are going to university, some of you are going to work, some of you apprenticeships, and the lucky ones are jumping straight into employment. But it is a privilege to do all of these things, especially those of you going to university. University is a privilege, and having that privilege, use it wisely. Giving some explanation to Naz Legacy Foundation. Naz Bokhari was a former head teacher of Ernest Bevin, before your time, before my time. But he left a legacy that his kids, Hina and Harris, wanted to continue, which was that he believed education was the main thing for young people and for students to bridge the gap, essentially, between from where you guys are now to where your teachers are, and even beyond. Normally I pass on a message when I've done this speech three times now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, three times. but one thing I'd say, as Bevin students and Bevin boys and Bevin graduates, you guys have a unique spark. And never let that go, wherever you go. And when you go to university, you'll meet people. And you'll try to fit in. And as nice as that is, don't forget where you came from. And don't forget who you currently are. Because that's what makes you who you are and will get you where you want to be. Question to all of you, including parents and maybe even teachers. Do you know what you want to do in the future? No, no one knows what they want to do.
Rubbish careers advice.
Does anyone know what their perfect job would be? No one. Wow. Mr. Roma, thank you. That was kind of my point. So whatever path you go down, make sure you enjoy it. And always ask yourself the question, if I wasn't being paid to do this, would I still do it? Mr. Dave, if you weren't paid for this, would you still do it?
Absolutely. Yeah, I would.
But it's, you're always asked for advice being, I just graduated from university. And so you always ask for advice for university and afterwards. Enjoy university, enjoy freshers. Freshers is an interesting week, to put it lightly. And definitely get involved, not only with societies, but your communities. Bevin is a community, and wherever you end up going, wherever in the country, that will be your community. And be part of it, and enjoy it. The award itself. The award gives the opportunity to the person to essentially do whatever they want. As you saw some pictures of some people, that, not the Rubik's Cube, some people were given the opportunity to go to the BBC, some people were given the opportunity to go to 10 Downing Street and even meet Mr. Speaker. These opportunities are available to us through the Naz Legacy Foundation and is something that not only his kids have provided us, but from far, far away, the late Mr. Bokhari has as well. The actual award goes to someone that has shown something further. So not only done the basics of getting good grades and getting a place in university, but has gone above and beyond and helped the Bevin community, but even the wider community. Apparently there was lots of competition, I can't speak, but apparently there were loads of you that went up for this award because this year was as amazing as it is. The individual that got it got 2 A stars and an A, and is going to the University of Bath to do psychology. A round of applause for Viknesh Jeevachandran.
Thank you, I guess. I only heard about this just recently, literally today, so it's quite a shock. Those of you who know me, this is going to be a short speech, I haven't written anything. I guess Ernest Bevin, my first year in year 7, I was bitter about not being into Bevin. And then I thought maybe I'll transfer in the second year or something, but then I guess that was naivety, and when the years went by, all these 7 long years, all the different teachers and all the different staff members and students and friends I've made, and I think it really did show to me that you can't have, you know, don't judge a book by its cover, because I wouldn't be where I am without the help of everybody in this college today. Back to Mr. Oddy, who didn't give me a heads up. What's good? Why? Nope, you didn't work. Really happy to get one of these. I've never got one of these before. I like to keep a low profile, but I guess it's something to put on my mantelpiece, right, Mum?
You've got to give it back.
Good evening, everyone.